I was teaching then at New York University, which was a pioneer in racial integration. Indeed, as a big university in so cosmopolitan a city as New York, with its large Negro community, the issue never really arose. I soon found out that there was an unwritten rule providing that Negro students should be marked about 2 grades higher than whites for a given level of work. If a newcomer on the faculty deviated in his innocence from this rule when he turned in his first midterm grade sheets, discreet words to the wise were communicated to him by his older colleagues, so that no lasting damage would be done by an unsuitable end-of-term grade that would have gone into the student's permanent record. One literal-minded young instructor, who refused to take those prudent hints, found himself the physical focus of the dean's office, the student's parents and uncle, a delegation from the NAACP, and a suave representative of City Hall. Naturally, the liberals on the faculty, that is, most of the faculty, had no difficulty justifying this rule to themselves, though they never did get around to recognizing it in public.